Janik, I think I need to fart.
Not in the car, Jordy.
Okay, can you pull over then?
I can't do that. I think the car might explode if I slow down.
Damn it. Then there's no other way but to jump on the roof of the car.
Jordy, be safe.
I will.
Please.
What's up, everyone? My name is Jordy for Cinecom.net, and welcome to Copycat Friday, a weekly series where we recreate an effect from a film or music video. And Janik is the one who still believes farts are funny. It wasn't me. True story.
It was your idea, Jordy!
Now, first up, a big shout out to our sponsor, Rocketstock, who came out with a brand new video pack called Lucent Precise. Now, this pack consists out of 110 super sharp lens flares that were all captured using super fast Zeiss prime lenses going from 16 to 85 millimeters. We actually used several of them in the intro and they came out pretty nice. To find out more, click the first link in the description below. Now, jumping on the roof of a car is dangerous, which is why we're going to fake it. And of course, otherwise, we also wouldn't have anything to explain. Now, the idea actually comes from various sources. Standing on a riding car is seen in many Hollywood action films, such as The Fast and the Furious, Marvel's new Black Panther, which many of you guys actually mentioned on Instagram. Now, I actually got this idea from a suggested video that popped up on my YouTube's homepage, and I thought by myself, I need to recreate this.
Right here are C-stands, and we're going to use them to hang up the green screen! I just skateboarded. Stand back, guys. You always need them. They're heavyweights. Gotta catch!
Catch!
Now, when we are going to film the car driving, there's going to be a lot of shake in that shot, and we're going to have to match the motion of that shakiness with the car, which is going to stand still. So that is why I'm going to add some tracking marks to the window of this car right here. And you can always add a couple of more points in here, because after you've made your shot and in After Effects you're noticing that some of these tracking marks will not do its job as you were hoping for, then you always have kind of a backup to use another tracking mark.
We first took the shots of the actual car driving, and then we took the matching green screen shots. And that allowed us to first draw the perspective of the driving car with a water marker on our display. And this helped us to create the exact same camera angle on the green screen set. A second thing that you need to pay attention to is the lighting direction. Remember the angle of the sunlight in your driving shot so that you can position your green screen car the same way. Important is that this shot is super steady, so you want to film this from a tripod. And to make it even more realistic than I'm crawling on a driving car, we have Lorenzo, who is doing an amazing internship here at Cinecom, blowing wind with a leaf blower.
Windy! Very, very windy!
These are the only two shots that you need, which you can already import into After Effects. The driving shot goes first in a new composition, and with that layer selected, open up the tracker window. Now, last week, we've also taken a look at the camera tracker, which will analyze and track the movement of the camera. In this case, it's different. We want to track the motion of an object. So what I'm going to do is click on track motion, and then you have to enable to track the position, rotation, and scale. Very important. That'll give you two tracking points, which we're going to position on those window markers. And you need to have at least two marks, because only then After Effects can calculate a change in position or rotation. Once they're in place, just hit the track forward button and wait it out. If your tracking points go crazy, then try changing the size of your tracking points. And once the tracking is complete, I head over to the menu, click on Layer, New, Null Object. A new layer will be added to your composition, and it actually doesn't do anything. but we're going to use it to store this tracking data in it. So from the tracker window, click on Edit Target and choose that null object. Then you can hit Apply and press OK. You will now notice that this null object will stick to the window, and that means everything went like it should.
Static! Catch!
And then you want to add your green screen shot on top in the composition. Take the pen tool from the toolbox and draw a rough mask around the window and a portion of the green screen. Then I head over to the effects library and apply the key light effect to that clip, which allows me to remove all the green. Now heading back to the layer, I press the T button on my keyboard to change the opacity to something around 50%. And now we can see through that clip, which makes it easier for me to match it with the driving car. You can now rescale, position, and rotate that clip. And once it matches perfectly, I'm changing the opacity back to 100. And now the only thing left to do is to make sure that the clip stays on the same position. So with the whip tool in your layers, I can drag and connect it to the null object, which holds that tracking data. And that's all you have to do! Now just apply your favorite color grading, some Lucent precise lens flares, and you got yourself an action hero film! And that was it again, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Rocketstock, for the support today. And make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. And don't forget to join the notification squad to be the first to see us twice a week. But most importantly, stay creative.
Jordy, catch!